Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear learners, how are you? I am fine. I think you are also fine. By the grace of Almighty Allah. I think you are staying at home. Everybody, we know that your school is closed because of coronavirus. And that is why you are staying at home. And you are following the rules of coronavirus for protecting you. Dear learners, you know that digital class is going on. In that way, this way, today, I am going to discuss English first paper, class 8. Welcome to you in this class. Dear learners, today's topic is Bangladeshi cuisine, Unit 1, Lesson 5. Dear learners, look at the blackboard. First, I will discuss the keywords. There are some keywords I have written on the board. You look at the blackboard. First one, cuisine. That means style of cooking. Platter, that means shallow, flat, what dish. That means big, we can say big dish. It is necessarily used in wedding ceremony. Marriage ceremony. And molasses, next word, molasses, thick platter. It is kind of, we can say, good, dead. And next word, delicious. Delicious means highly pleasing to the taste. Highly pleasing to the taste. And next word, appetizing, exciting the appetite. Next word, snacks. Snacks means a hasty light meal. A hasty light meal. And last word, winter. Winter, that means cold. Yeah, Nana. As our school is closed, you are distant from us a long distance. There is no opportunity to attend the class. So that is why I am going to read the lesson 5. You will look your book, textbook and listen to me very carefully about my pronunciation. Bangladeshi cuisine is rich and varied with the use of many spices. We have delicious and appetizing food, snacks and sweets. Boiled rice is our staple food. It is served with a variety of vegetables, curry, lentil soup, fish and meat. Fish is the main source of protein. Fishes are now cultivated in pot. Also, we have fresh water, fishes in the lakes and rivers. More than 40 types of fishes are common. Some of them are carp, rui, patla, magur, chingri, chutki, while dead fishes are popular. Fish is very popular among the people of Bangladesh. Panta irish is a traditional platter of panta bhat. It is steamed, diced, soaked in water, and served with a fried fish slice, often together with dried fish, pickles, lentil soup, green chilies, and onion. It is a popular dish on the Pohila Boishak. The people of Bangladesh are very fond of sweets. Among all Bangladeshi women, prepare some traditional sweets. Pita, a type of sweet made from rice flour, sugar, syrup, molasses, and sometimes meat is a traditional food loved by the entire population. During winter, Pitarutsav, meaning Pita festival, is organized by different groups of people. Sweets are distributed among close relatives when there is good news like birth, weddings, promotion, etc. Sweets of Bangladesh are very mostly milk-based. The common ones are rasgulla, sandesh, rasmalai, gulab jam, kaju jam, and chamcham. There are hundreds of different variants of sweet preparation. Sweets are therefore an important part of the day-to-day life of Bangladeshi people. Dear learners, you have listened to me very carefully. I think you listened the pronunciation of the words from the text. Dear learners, now I am going to discuss Section C. There are some sentences in Section C. Look at your book and Section C. Number one, our foods are rich because they have a lot of oil in them. It is not correct. Correct answer, our foods are rich because they have lot of spices. We get protein mostly from fish. It also incorrect. Correct answer, we get protein from meat, fish, etc. Number three, on Poila Boishakh, the traditional food is steamed rice and fried dishes. It is correct. Pita Utsav takes place almost all the year round in Bangladesh. It is not correct. Pita Utsav takes place only Poila Boishakh or Navanno Utsav. Number five, sweets are not much appreciated by the people of Bangladesh. Not correct. Correct answer, sweets are much appreciated by the people of Bangladesh. Dear learners, then now I am going to tell you that you will read the story very, very carefully with the meaning of the words and passage. If you read the story again and again, you will answer the true false, you will answer the first question, you will make a paragraph. So you will practice again and again. There is proof of that. Practice makes a man perfect. So I hope you will read it very carefully and you will stay at home because of coronavirus, and you will use mask without using mask. You will not out of your house, and you will take care of your health. No more today. Thank you. May Allah bless you.